playing Pikmin. It's one of my favorite games, and you know, since they just announced the fourth one, I might as well start playing. I'm gonna play again. Get all hyped for the new one. I don't know what, we don't know when it's coming out, but shouldn't be too long. When did they announce that? Like, I think that was November. It's somewhere around November. That's most likely when it was announced. So that, well, I mean, I guess it could take longer, but like, I think they're just using the same graphics as the third one. But enough said. Let's get into Pikmin. Man, this intro is very long. I don't remember it being this long. My name is Captain Olimar. While traveling through space, my ship was struck by a meteor. I must have blacked out, and I woke on the surface of this weird planet. With so many parts lost, the skeleton hull of my beloved dolphin is a painful sight. Ugh. Sound like I've fucking never read before. The engine is gone. I'm stranded. To make matters worse, Amatospheric sensor. Damn, I don't know how to fucking pronounce the word. I'm so dyslexic. God, fuck! I don't know. Fuck words. Sensors indicate the planet's environment contains high levels of poisonous oxygen. My life support system can function for only 30 days. If I can't repair the dolphin by then, no. Better not to think about it. I must find the missing ship parts. Okay. Minus that terrible fucking narration. Let's continue with this game. I just enjoy this game. It's fun. I just like the premise that you just have to go find your ship parts with these little creatures. Ooh. I got some frame drops right there, damn. I don't know if I'm gonna be narrating that much, as you can tell by the beginning. I didn't do that fucking good of a job. I'll try my best though. The seed that the onion dropped took root in the soil. And I have now produced it. God, that was really annoying. The soil, and I have now produced an adorable little sprout. The sprout emits a strange light, and it sways back and forth, without benefit of the wind, or of wind. Huh? I just never heard someone use that term before. The benefit of the wind? Oh, I'm fucking stupid. It's not using the wind. It's just doing it back and forth on its own. Okay. It's a little red man. Extraordinary. Why I actually knew that one. When I plucked the sprout, it turned out to be a living creature, not a plant. Picking it has done no visible damage. It just stands there staring at me. Its shape is familiar to the pick carrot brand carrots. Huh. That's a weird word. Pick brand carrot. Wait, did I say that wrong? The first time? Pick brand carrots. Now that I said it again, it doesn't sound like I said it the first time. I love so much. He loves the carrots. I believe I shall call it a Pikmin. Here I am, stranded on a toxic planet, fighting. God damn it! I hate the little clicking noise. Fighting to survive, and yet I'm intrigued. I think that's intrigued. I must research this fascinating creature. I shall try to grab it and throw it with a and I will call it to my side with B. Perhaps I will react. It will react to C and X as well. Yeah? The following control. Why does he even? How does he even know this? Why does he even know A, X, Z, and Y? I never actually sat down and just thought about it. The following controls appear to follow me several viewpoints. Rotate camera, hold to follow the sensor. Zoom in and out. Change angle. I must survive. I need to familiarize myself with these controls in my surroundings. All right. Oh my god. I don't know if you guys can see it, but like the screen's like glitching out for me. Uh-oh. My screen looks delayed. Okay, I might be a little delayed. Like the inputs and stuff. But there's not really nothing I can control about that, so that sucks. Fuck off. I'm not narrating no more. I'm clearly not cut out for the job. Yeah, why am I delayed? I don't know why I'm delayed. Oh wait, let me try fixing something real quick. Okay, that's a little better. I'm using OBS for this, and I put it in full screen, but that might have been a bad idea. So I'm just gonna have to hope. It doesn't do this for the rest of the gameplay. Because if it is delayed like this, this is going to be so painful to play. But I will just have to get used to it. Oof. My god. I actually just don't know the reason. I just don't know what the problem is. Definitely in the next episode, I will fix that. No doubt about it, I will fix that. Oh man, it is so... I gotta get off this topic, this whole video has just been me complaining about me being dyslexic and talking about how this is delayed. I should be bringing more cheers to this. Okay, so... Yes, carry that. I need these guys back over here. You can, by the way, you can let them stay in the ground and they'll just get flowered. But that will take fucking, like, 20 minutes. You also, there's no timer, so you can stay in here as long as you want. So I think I'm just gonna make this the episode. Just day one. And then start day two out with the... what is it called? I can never remember. I think it's the Forest of Hope. There's the Forest of Hope, the Garden of Hope, and then I don't remember the other one. It's for the three games. I just don't know their names. Unless they just reused one. I like how it just takes place. The Pikmin are curious. I like how this game takes place when humans are extinct and you can just see all this human technology and stuff. Technology, speaking of cardboard boxes, batteries, I don't really know what else there is, but I'll surely figure that out in a second. What? Isn't it? Oh, there he is. Good. This episode is not really nothing special. Nothing really is happening. I was thinking about doing another one, like another day, but I think I'm gonna say this is just gonna be like the tutorial. Get rid of all this. It's just gonna be me explaining, like, what I'm doing and stuff. and like what this game's like about. Cause I don't know. There's nothing special. When many Pikmin sprout or seeds sprout at once, I'll find it rather tender. I just explained that one. It's about like how the Pikmin, if you leave them in the ground, they start being flowerized. There's three stages for them. There's the flower, budding, and then there's the leaf. Leaf's the weakest. In this game has some weird like mechanics. Like if the, like say when I throw them at the beginning, I think you saw that at the very beginning. Oh, I'm missing a Pikmin, but when I threw it at that flower over there, it just ran back towards me. In this game, they change that. They have it so that they just always come back. And the issue with that, you have to throw them and then cancel for them to actually pick up the item and carry it back. If you don't do that, they just run back to you, and it kind of ruins like the plans you have with it. Another issue is that in this game, when Pikmin trip all the time, it's so annoying. Because you can be running, and you're trying to get to somewhere really quickly, they'll just trip over, and then it takes them a very long time to get up. But I found a quick way to do it is that if you just cancel your Pikmin, like, here, I'll just demonstrate. Canceling, I didn't show all the controls. Come here. Yeah, it's like that, they just always pick things up, but say like, hold on, let me try getting one to trip. Come on. Trip. It's when you're doing quick movements like this, they trip usually. Maybe, you know what, maybe it's because I'm in this area right now, that it's not letting them trip. But like, it's like, say like one trips, if you cancel it, they'll get up instantly. That's faster than like, you know, letting them just get up and walk back to you. What else is there? Oh. There's a C-stick where you can like have them just move like this. Which is nice, and if you do it correctly, you can, if you have them swarm really quick towards you. Oh, I have an alarm going off. Give me 1 second. Sorry about that. If you go like this, swarm them next to you, you can throw them really quick. Which is really nice. And there's another one where what you do is, it's when you have to throw a Pikmin. If you throw a Pikmin and then you had them all go like that, they instantly go to a spot. So in this game, so in Pikmin, if you throw a Pikmin, what it does is its AI tries to find a spot to grab, which can grab anywhere, but they take forever to find a spot. But if you throw a Pikmin, it instantly locks onto one, and they all just, for some reason, instantly know where to go. Which is cool. It's a nice mechanic, but the second game's a lot better. Like, there's a glitch in this game when you're built. In the next episode, we're gonna be, like, building a bridge. But any Pikmin underneath a bridge, when it's being built, they just die. And there's other ones where, like, when you kill an enemy, and like it falls onto a Pikmin, it pushes them under the ground and it basically gets rid of them. So you can't like, you have to be careful on that. There's one of the enemies in the game, it's like a mushroom. It's the worst. Because when it dies, it expands. I've gotten better at it, but usually it would take a Pikmin. It'll take one or two, and it's just, ugh, it's just terrible. That's about it. I mean, that was just day one, the tutorial. What else? I mean, I am probably gonna beat this game in 9 days. That's the fastest I can do. You have 30 days. I'm most likely gonna try doing it as fast as possible, cause I just like doing it. But yeah, that's about it. Nothing more about the game. I mean, like, there's this, where every day he has a new, like, quote, or, like, new, like, message. Day one's always the same. If a Pikmin dies by a bomb. Yeah, you know, I'm spoiling the game too much. I'm spoiling it too much. I'm introducing all these new mechanics that haven't even been shown. But yeah. That was day one.
The tutorial day. In the next episode, we leave the impact site and we're going straight to the Forest of Hope. It was the Forest of Hope.
Yeah, and the Forest. See, that meter down there at the bottom, I just fucking pointed at the TV. Yeah, as you can see, it's at the bottom left. It has like a little. It looks. You can see my ship down there. That indicates how many ship parts you have. Right now, I have 1 of 30. Pretty basic. If I press Y, it just does the log, so I can go back to the diaries and reread them. I never use this mechanic, but I guess it's a nice one to have. Up there is your day meter. I have 2 days. I'm on day 2. The red onion next to the ship, it tells you how many Pikmin you have in it, which is nice. Each area is named and it has ship parts in the area. This little star counter means how many there are, and the gold one is the one you have already collected. This area, I think, has 9. I think it has 9, or maybe it's 8. It's 8. It has 8 ship parts. And then this one has 2. But I can't go back here, because, you know, I don't know if you saw it, but there's a giant wall in the way. And I can't get it through that. But, yeah. Alright, that was a tutorial. That was pretty fun. Since this was a shorter video, I think I can get this one done quickly. I can get the next episode done. So, I think I'm just going to tackle this whole area. The Forest of Hope. I think I'm just going to get rid of it. So, that's 8 ship parts. That's, if I can get like 4 a day, that's fine. We'll be good. Yeah. Well, that was the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Next episode, again, we're tackling the Forest of Hope. We'll try finishing it tomorrow. I'm gonna try record tomorrow. Yeah. I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.